Hello once again, welcome back. Today we are starting with a new chapter, that is linear equations in two variables. Already we have seen something about quadratic equation, a quadratic equation of the form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0 will be called as a quadratic equation since its degree is 2. Now suppose if you are having an equation with one variable. अगर हमारे पास एक इक्वेशन है 5x plus 3 is equal to 13 और से minus 13 से for example. So this is a linear equation because its degree is 1 and it is having only one variable, that is x here. So solving a linear equation in one variable is a very simple thing which we have studied in 7th standard itself. How to solve this one? Just connect the like terms. So 5x is equal to 13 minus 3 or 5x is equal to 10 or x is equal to 2. So x is equal to 2 is a solution of linear equation in one variable in this particular case. So if you are having only one equation and one variable, this one equation is sufficient to solve it. Solve means to get the value of x, to find the value of the variable. That means if I substitute the value of x is equal to t here, 5 plus 10 plus 3 13. So this equation is satisfied. But suppose instead, if you are having something like this one, 5x plus 3y is equal to 13. Now, this is also a linear equation because the degree of this equation is 1. But it is having two variables, x and y. That means 5x plus 3y is equal to 13. To make the things simpler, I will just give you some situation. Say for example, if we buy 2 kgs of apple and 3 kgs of say any other fruit. Say 3 grapes and apples, say for example, 2 kgs of grapes and 3 kgs of apple. So it costs me say 100 rupees. But when I change the quantity, when I take 5 kgs of grapes and 1 kg of apple, it costed me say 120 rupees. So what is the cost of 1 kg of apple and 1 kg of grapes? This situation. That means we are having two variables. Yahan pe do entities kon kon se hain, grapes and apples. And we are supposed to find the cost of each kg of apple and grapes. In this situation, mein, grapes as well as apples are two entities, are two personalities jisko humko find karna hai. Right? So, aise situation, mein, we need to have two variables. But one equation is not sufficient to solve it. Now, we can get some values of x and find corresponding values of y. Right? जैसे कि हमने 9th standard में to draw the graph of an equation हम क्या करते थे, एक equation दिया हुआ रहता था, right? Then we used to make a box something like this. Then we used to have x and y. Then we used to assume certain values for x and we used to find values for y. Suppose if I take x is equal to 1 minus 1 3, 2, say 0. And we used to find corresponding values of y. You know? So when x is 1, the 5 ones are 5 plus 3y is equal to 30. So 3y is equal to 8 and y is equal to 8 upon 3. So when x is 1, y is 8 upon 3. When x is minus 1, x is minus 1. So this is minus 5 plus 3y is equal to 30. So 3y is equal to 18 or y is equal to 18 upon 3. This is 18 upon 3. When x is 3, 5 threes are 15. So 3y is equal to 13. 15 becomes minus. Minus 15. So 3y is equal to 2 and y is equal to 2 upon 3. So y is 2 upon 3. So for every value of x, we have got a corresponding value of y. That means this set of values, x equal to 1, y is equal to 8 upon 3, will satisfy this equation. So if you are having a linear equation in two variables, it will have infinite number of solutions. In fact, why these equations are called as linear equation? Because when we draw the graph, we get a line. To line se linear bana hai. Ek chota sa example aur ek lenge, simple example lenge. If x plus y is equal to say 10. If I ask you, ki bhai, give me two numbers, whose sum is 10? Whose sum is 10? तो एक बच्चा उठकर बोलेगा सर x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 9. x equal to 1, y is equal to 9 because 1 plus 9 is 10. And he is right. लेकिन दूसरी बच्ची निकलेगी और बोलेगी कि सर I can have x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 8. And she is also correct because 8 plus 2 is 10. फिर और एक बच्ची उठेगी और बोलेगी कि सर x is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to 11 because this is also plus 10. So linear equation in two variables raha, and if you got only one equation, it will have infinite number of solutions. Right. So what is the basic requirement? Basic requirement is, if you are having linear equations in two variables, at least kam se kam हमको दो इक्वेशंस होने चाहिए जिसको हम सॉल्व करेंगे एंड वी कैन गेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई व्हिच विल साइमल्टेनियसली सेटिस्फाई बोथ द इक्वेशन. मतलब एक ऐसा सॉल्यूशन जो पहला इक्वेशन और दूसरे इक्वेशन दोनों को सेटिस्फाई करने वाला है, वी कैन गेट दैट वैल्यूज. राइट. सो टू सॉल्व लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल्स वी गॉट डिफरेंट मेथड्स. वी हैव गॉट ग्राफिकल मेथड, we have got algebraic methods. Right. So graphical method means, if we draw the graph, right, to humko ek graph paper lena padega, dono equation ke graphs draw karne padenge, aur jahan pe graph intersect hote hain, that point is the solution. That is graphical method. Then algebraic methods mein we got some three different methods are there. Ek aata hai substitution method, dusra aata hai elimination method, third one is either called as cross multiplication method or is also known as determinant method. Right. So ye jo cross multiplication method hai ya determinant method hai, it has been deleted for the time being, but although it has been deleted, we are going to solve it. Matlab aap usko zyada practice mat karo, lekin aapko malum to hona chahiye ki ye method hai kya cheez. All right. So coming back to this chapter once again, to aaj hum पहला मेथड जो है ग्राफिकल मेथड. वी आर गोइंग टू डू सम क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन ग्राफिकल मेथड. नाउ बिफोर वी गो इनटू दिस वन, तो आपको याद रहेगा कि जब हम नाइन्थ में एक चैप्टर पे हमने ग्राफ ड्रॉ करना एक क्वेश्चन लेना था, एक लीनियर इक्वेशन दिया हुआ था एंड वी वर सपोज टू ड्रॉ द ग्राफ ऑफ दोस इक्वेशंस. राइट. एक सिंपल सा एग्जांपल लेंगे हम, 2x plus 3y is equal to 6. If we draw the graph of this equation, अभी इसका graph कैसे बनाना है? Just now we have discussed. Once again, I'll just tell you. We'll just make a box. Right. Then we'll have say x and y. We'll have some values of x and corresponding values of y. Say suppose if I take x equal to 0. If I take x equal to say 4 3 5 10 12 say x equal to 6 x equal to 3 then x equal to minus 6 ऐसे कुछ वैल्यूज मिलेंगे मैंने जानबूझ के ऐसे वैल्यूज लिया जो कि विच आर डिविजिबल बाय 3 मतलब हमको एक इंटीजर मिलेगा. सो व्हेन x is 0 तो 2 0 0 3 y is equal to 6 therefore y is equal to. So when x is 0, y is 2. Right? अच्छा, आपको एक डाउट आ सकता है, can we take y के वैल्यूज? Yes, I can take y equal to 0. है ना? If I take y equal to 0, so 3y, मतलब 3, 0 is 0, 2x is equal to 6, x is equal to 3.
तो देन वाई इज जीरो,
एक्स इज थ्री, राइट। सपोज हमने एक्स लिया था सिक्स, तो सिक्स का ट्वेल्व, ट्वेल्व इधर जाएगा, इट बिकम सिक्स माइनस ट्वेल्व इज माइनस सिक्स एंड वाई इज इक्वल टू माइनस टू। सो वेन एक्स इज सिक्स वाई इज माइनस टू, वेन एक्स इज थ्री टू थ्री इज अ सिक्स, है ना, वेन एक्स इज थ्री, तो ये जो हमने देखा था यार दिस विल बिकम जीरो, करंट एक्स इक्वल टू माइनस सिक्स, सो टू इंटू माइनस सिक्स इज माइनस ट्वेल्व, माइनस ट्वेल्व इधर जाएगा बिकम्स प्लस ट्वेल्व, ट्वेल्व प्लस सिक्स इज एटीन, एटीन डिवाइड बाई थ्री इज सिक्स, समथिंग लाइक दिस। And then we plot these points. A graph paper thing. You just plot these points. मैं ये बहुत डिटेल में नहीं पढ़ा रहा हूँ क्योंकि already we have done it in 9th standard. Earlier classes में हमने किया हुआ है. So when x is 0, y is 2. X is 0, y is 2. समझ रही हैं? मैं roughly ले रहा हूँ. When x is 6, y is minus 2. Right? When x is 6, y is minus 2. Somewhere here. Somewhere. When y is 0, x is 3. Somewhere here it will be minus 6, 6. X ka 6, y ka minus 6. Somewhere here it will be. And you will find that this will be a straight line. Ye ek straight line rahega. Matlab har jo point iske upar rahega will satisfy this equation. Ye equation ko. Every point on this line will satisfy this equation. Agree? Once again, ये जो हमने points जो plot किए थे, वो हमने वो points लिए थे जो इस equation को satisfy कर रहे हैं. So conversely, can we say that any point on this line will satisfy this equation? Definitely yes, है ना? तो जब हमको ये second equation भी दिया हुआ रहेगा, second equation भी दिया हुआ रहेगा. So 2x plus 3y is equal to 6, और हमको बोला गया है कि 5x plus 2y is equal to 17. से एग्जांपल कुछ भी ऐसा रैंडम एग्जांपल लिया है मैंने. So अगर हमको ये सॉल्व करना है ग्राफिकली, मतलब यूजिंग ग्राफिकल मेथड, अगर हमको ये सॉल्व करना है तो हम क्या करेंगे, विल टेक द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन, सबसे पहले ग्राफिकल पर लेंगे, ग्राफिकली सॉल्व करना है तो ग्राफिकल पर लेना पड़ेगा हमको. Before that, we'll have to have some calculations. जैसे कि first equation के लिए हमने ये table बनाया था, वैसे second equation के लिए और एक table बनेगा, जिसमें x and y के values रहेंगे. I'll not go into details. So पहला equation के पहले calculations हमने x और y के coordinates मिल गए हुए हैं, points मिल गए हुए हैं. So if we draw the graph of this equation, first equation का जो मैंने graph बनाया, suppose वो ऐसे आया. So what is the meaning? This is equation number one. This is equation number one. And what is the meaning of this one? Every point on this graph will satisfy the first equation only. I cannot say about the second equation because second equation का तुमने graph अभी तक draw नहीं किया है. Suppose मैंने second equation का भी graph draw किया and say for example the graph comes out like this. Example बोला, this may not be true. So this is equation number 2. So every point on the second graph will satisfy the second equation. Har ek point jo second graph pe hoga wo second equation ko satisfy karega, hai na. So there is one and only one point here in this case, ek aisa point hai which lies on the first graph as well as the second graph. And what is the meaning of that? This is, it tells us that this point is going to satisfy this equation as well as the second equation. मतलब पहला equation भी ये satisfy करेगा, उनसे इसके coordinates, मतलब यहाँ पे जो x coordinate रहेगा और जो y coordinate रहेगा, suppose this is 1 and 2. So 1 and 2 will satisfy, this point 1, 2 lies on the equation 1 and equation 2, that means the graph of the equation 1 and 2. So definitely this is going to satisfy the first equation as well as the second equation. And that is the solution of this equation. Simultaneous linear equations. Yeah, linear equations in two variables. See, this linear equations in two variables is sometimes also called as simultaneous linear equations. Simultaneous linear equation. That means ye dono situations jo hai. Ye dono situations एक पर्टिकुलर कंडीशन देने के लिए दिया हुआ है। मतलब जैसे मैंने आपको बताया था कि सपोज इफ आई बाय 2 kgs ऑफ ग्रेप्स एंड 3 kgs ऑफ एप्पल, इट कॉस्टेड मी सपोज 100 rupees। इफ आई टेक 4 kgs ऑफ ग्रेप्स एंड 3 kgs ऑफ एप्पल, देन इट विल गिव अस समथिंग डिफरेंट। तो द कंडीशंस इज सेम ना, एप्पल्स एंड ग्रेप्स ले रहे हैं हम, पर किलो का रेट फिक्स है एंड वी आर सपोज टू फाइंड द कॉस्ट ऑफ ईच kg ऑफ ग्रेप्स एंड एप्पल्स। समझ में आ रहा है? सो ग्राफिकल मेथड इज नथिंग बट इट इज एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द 9th स्टैंडर्ड में हमने जो कुछ किया है उसका एप्लीकेशन है। मतलब दो इक्वेशंस दिए हुए रहेंगे आपको, ये दो इक्वेशंस के हमको दोनों ग्राफ बनाने पड़ेंगे, जहां पे ये ग्राफ इंटरसेक्ट होता है दैट इज द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दैट पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस। डेफिनेटली आपको यहां पे डाउट आना चाहिए 100%। अगर आप कॉन्सेंट्रेटेडली अगर इसके बारे में सोच रहे हैं तो आपको एक डाउट आना चाहिए। यस, डाउट ये है कि अगर मैंने ग्राफ बनाया और वो ग्राफ इंटरसेक्ट नहीं हुआ, राइट? पहला एक आपको डाउट आएगा ये है। हो सकता है कि व्हेन वी ड्रॉ द ग्राफ, व्हेन वी ड्रॉ द ग्राफ, द ग्राफ मे बी पैरेलल टू ईच अदर। हो सकता है कि दोनों ग्राफ जो है दे विल बी पैरेलल लाइक दिस, तो डेफिनेटली दे डू नॉट इंटरसेक्ट। तो कोई एक वैल्यू, पेयर ऑफ वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई विल नॉट सेटिस्फाई बोथ द इक्वेशन और बोथ द ग्राफ साइमल्टेनियसली। इन दैट केस द पेयर ऑफ इक्वेशंस विल बी कॉल्ड एज इनकंसिस्टेंट। वो कंसिस्टेंट नहीं है, इट इज इनकंसिस्टेंट, and then hence they will not have any solution। So जब graph intersect होता है तो हमको उसका solution मिलता है, hence it is consistent। And since two lines when intersect, they intersect in one and only one point, so they will have unique solution। Here in this case, since the graphs are parallel to each other, they will not intersect with each other, but definitely they are inconsistent, hence they will not have any solutions। और एक ऑप्शन हो सकता है, हो सकता है कि जब हम ग्राफ ड्रॉ करें एक ग्राफ ऐसे आ जाए और दूसरा ग्राफ उसी पे कोइंसाइड हो जाए। सो एवरी पॉइंट ऑन दिस ग्राफ ऑल्सो लाइज ऑन द फर्स्ट ग्राफ ऑल्सो, दैट मीन्स दो ग्राफ एक दूसरे को ओवरलैप कर रहे हैं। दैट मीन्स एवरी पॉइंट ऑन द फर्स्ट ग्राफ ऑल्सो लाइज ऑन द सेकेंड ग्राफ, means all these points will satisfy the both the equations। In that case definitely we have solutions, so consistent hai, so they have got infinite number of solutions। So teen alag alag type ke cases humne dekha hua hai, ek when they intersect each other, graph jo intersect hote hain they have unique solution consistent, when they are parallel to each other inconsistent, no solutions, when they coincide with each other they are consistent since they have got solutions and infinitely many solutions। So when they intersect or coincide they are consistent, when they are parallel they are inconsistent। Now अभी और एक डाउट आपके दिमाग में आएगा कि क्या सर every time हमको ये graph बना के ही मालूम पड़ेगा कि consistent है या unique solution है या no solution है या फिर infinitely many solution, ऐसा कुछ algebraic method है जिससे हम ये पता कर सकें without drawing the graph। क्या हम पता कर सकते हैं कि whether the graphs or the equations are consistent, equations are consistent, अगर consistent है तो unique solution है या फिर infinitely many solutions हैं, या फिर अगर inconsistent है तो graph will be parallel and hence no solution। So definitely we have got algebraic methods and those methods are important from the subject point of view also, and when you go into the 11th and 12th standard to aapko wo conditions ke upar bahut sare questions rahenge, to aapko yaad to rakhna hai as well as you have to understand the concept also, right? The concept part I'll take you afterwards, the particular concept jo hai uska derivation aapko baad mein dunga main aapko, बिकॉज उसके लिए हमको क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन मेथड या फिर डिटरमिनेंट मेथड भी समझ में आना चाहिए। विल टेक इट afterwards. बट फॉर द टाइम being, अगर हमको ग्राफ ड्रॉ करना है, सॉरी ग्राफिकल विदाउट ड्राइंग द ग्राफ, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट whether with set of conditions, है ना, कि what are the conditions required for the graph to be consistent and inconsistent and all these things. So कोई भी general linear equations in two variables जो रहता है वो किस फॉर्म में रहता है? It is a1x plus b1y is equal to c1, a2x plus b2y is equal to c2. मतलब ये कहने का मतलब है कि this is a general form. एक्चुअली अगर हम देखा जाए तो ये जो समथिंग लाइक दिस वन, 2x plus 3y is equal to 6 and 7x minus 4y is equal to 3. So पहले इक्वेशन का x का जो कोएफिशिएंट रहेगा दैट इज a1, y का कोएफिशिएंट इट इज रिलेटेड बाय b1 एंड दिस इज कांस्टेंट c1. वैसे ही a2, b2 एंड c2. द ट्रिक जो है इट इज वेरी सिंपल, यू हैव टू जस्ट रिमेंबर वन थिंग. आपको क्या करना है, लुकिंग एट द इक्वेशंस, लुकिंग एट द इक्वेशन यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द रेशियोज ऑफ a1 अपॉन a2, b1 upon b2 and c1 upon c2. Matlab, we'll just find the ratios a1 upon a2, b1 upon b2 and c1 upon c2. Now looking at this, comparing this with this particular question, agar hum to general form se agar hum dekhen, what is a1 upon a2? a1 upon a2 is 2 by 7, b1 upon b2 is 3 upon minus 4 means minus 3 by 4 and C1 by C2 is 6 upon 3 that is equal to 2 upon 1. Now, आपको करना क्या है? अगर A1 upon A2 पहला condition case 1, if the A1 upon A2 is not equal to B1 upon B2. अगर A1 upon A2 is not equal to B1 upon B2, in that case, it is consistent and unique solution. Unique मतलब one and only one, एक ही solution रहेगा. So एक ही solution, pair of linear equations में अगर एक ही solution है, उसके लिए condition क्या है? A1 upon A2 should not be equal to B1 upon B2. So if A1 upon A2 is not equal to B1 upon B2, now here also A1 upon A2 is 2 by 7, B1 upon B2 is 3 minus 3 by 4. They are not equal. So if you solve these pair of linear equations, you will get unique solution and definitely the graph will intersect at one point. Alright? Case 2. Suppose पहला equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 6 दिया है, 4x plus 6y is equal to 12 ऐसा दिया हुआ है. So case 2, if a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2. अब हम case 2 पे कब जाएंगे? जब then a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, then only we'll go for case 2. अगर केस वन में ही सेटिस्फाई हो गए हम कि a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, तो जो भी कंसिस्टेंट एंड यूनिक सॉल्यूशन. तो अगर सेकंड केस में हम कब जाएंगे? जब व्हेन a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 and is also equal to c1 upon c2. मतलब a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 is equal to c1 upon c2. In that case, it will be consistent and many solutions. Many मतलब infinite number of solutions. Here in this case, 2 upon 4, you know, a1 upon a2, a1 upon b2 is 2 upon 4, b1 upon b2 is 3 by 6, and c1 upon c2 is 6 upon 12. 2 upon 4 means 1 upon 2, 3 by 6 is also 1 by 2, 6 by 12 is also 1 upon 2. That means A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 is equal to C1 upon C2 equal to 1 by 2. So, अब आप बोलेंगे कैसे किया सर, मैंने इस equation को 2 से multiply किया. तो ये equation why same? जब same equations रहेंगे, तो the solutions, they will have infinite number of solutions and it will be consistent and have many solutions or infinite number of solutions. And a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 ion, lekin it is not equal to c1 upon c2. That is case 3 then. Case 3 kya rahega? If a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 but not equal to c1 upon c2. Ye dono bhi equal hai but c1 upon c2 equal nahi hai. Suppose ye 12 ki jagah to yahan pe 15 hai. Say for example. So ye ratio ho jayega 15. 3 2s and 3 5s, so this will be 2 upon 5. So, either was equal, but this is not equal to this one. That means condition kya hai? A1 upon A2, not equal, sorry, equal to B1 upon B2, but not equal to C1 upon C2. In that case, the equations will be inconsistent and no solutions. In fact, I advise before solving any linear equations in two variables by any of the methods, we have seen graphical method, right? But koi bhi method karne se pehle, ek roughly, rough mein, hai na? Just find out the values of a1 upon a2, b1 upon b2 and c1 upon c2 and just check it ki kya hoga karke, whether it will have infinite number of solutions or many solutions or no solutions. कभी कभी मतलब बहुत रेयर में हुआ है, लेकिन पुराने जमाने में जब 90s की बात हुआ करती थी, हमको जब पेपर आता था तो दे यूज टू गिव अस पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस. पूरा सॉल्व करने के बाद में हमको मालूम पड़ता था कि यार इसका इक्वेशन का सॉल्यूशन ही नहीं है, तो उतना हमारा टाइम वेस्ट हो जाता था, राइट? तो अगर हम पहले ही पता कर लें कि वेदर दीज इक्वेशंस विल हैव यूनिक सॉल्यूशंस और नो सॉल्यूशंस, अगर नो सॉल्यूशंस हैं तो वी कैन राइट दिस वन. ये स्टेटमेंट हम दे सकते हैं, सिंस a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 but not equal to c1 upon c2, द ग्राफ विल बी पैरेलल and you will have not have any solutions, then there is no need to solve it. Getting my point? So ye module mein hum yahi tak karenge. Next module mein we'll have some questions based on these conditions and two more algebraic methods of solving linear equations in two variables, right? Till then, goodbye.